Trabalho até aqui. Create repository. Click git bash here. Git add. That means I'm going to add all the files to the committing stage. In order to make this a directory or folder git recognizable, I need to initialize this folder by using git init command. Simply observe, I'm not going to tell you in detail anything. Later we are going to cover this. Then git add, I'm going to add all the files to the committing stage. Then I'm going to commit. Git commit with the message -m first commit. Then to clear the screen, we can go for clear. Then I'll come to the GitHub. Now, git branch. This is the main branch. I'm going to add the remote origin. Later I'm going to push it to the repository. I'll refresh this. You can find materials here. I'll copy this and I'm sending it in the chat. Now, let us see another program. Because I was not recording, this is very important. Come to the read plus, file, new, Java. Public static void main. String array of arguments. Dot 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 println. Hello. Hello world. Again. And again. save this. In the SRC, I'm going to say extension is optional because already type is selected as Java. Click on save. Now, the command prompt. To clear the screen in Windows, command prompt, we should give CLS. Now, what you should do initially, I'll close this command prompt. Once again, I'll open the command prompt here. CD. SRC folder location you need to copy. We have created a folder Java FSD 09211, then language fundamentals folder inside that app one, inside that other two folders called classes and SRC. Inside SRC, I have kept this source files a.java and b.java. I'm going to copy this entire path URL, paste it here, cd space, paste it here, right click, that will be pasted. Enter. Still we are not in the folder. For that, give the name of the directory, sorry, give the name of the drive. In my case it is F drive, F colon. Enter. Now it is pointing to that folder. Now trigger the command Java C hyphen D double dot forward slash classes B dot Java. Java C in the sense Java compiler. I'm going to invoke Java compiler, then hyphen D, it is the option that we are using along with the Java C command. Now double dot forward slash, that means go back to the previous directory. Currently I am in the SRC directory. Go back to the previous directory, that means to the app one. There you can find classes folder. In that classes folder, you need to keep generated class file. That is what I'm saying. B.java. Everything is fine. It is going to compile and it is going to keep dot class file in classes folder. Now the generated class file we are going to run, okay, by using Java command. Java then space -cp, -cp in the sense class path. We are going to use this -cp option along with the Java command. Class path, where class is available, that path I'm specifying here. Double dot forward slash, go back to the previous directory, classes, then just b, should not give b dot java, b dot class, just b. Another way is there, simply go to the classes folder, that means cd, double dot forward slash classes, go to the classes folder. Now we are in the classes folder. Now you can able to run b class. Simply say java space b, you'll get the. Instead of going to the classes folder again and again, simply I'll trigger the command in the src folder only. Cd double dot forward slash src. I'm going to the src folder. Here itself I'm going to trigger that command like this: java -cp double dot forward slash classes B. Like this. Great. Simply go for file, new Java file. In the previous versions, we were getting template, default template, but in the later, recent version, we are not getting the boilerplate code. What is boilerplate code? Simply will get Hello World program as the template. That we are not getting in the recent version of Edit Plus. Fine, no issues. It is great. We can be able to type class C. Now, observe, in the previous cases, I have not given any public keyword. Okay. Don't worry what is public. Now, what happens if I give public for this class? Carefully observe. Public static void main Simply I'm keeping done. No, observe, I'm saving this file. Save. Perfect, no issues. Now you can able to compile and run. I'm going to compile it. So in the keyboard, you can able to go for up arrow, down arrow for already used commands. I'm simply changing the name of the file, c.java. Then while running, I'm going for java-cp classes C. We are getting done message, no issues at all. To clear the screen, I'll say CLS. Now observe, file new Java. Simply I'll copy this everything to save the time, but in your case you should type. Pasting it here. Now I'm deleting this public. Okay, I'm going for D. Save this. Control S, D. Save. What I have done, I have given class name as the file name. I'll do one thing. I'll delete whatever I have saved. Okay, I don't want it. Once again, I'll try to save. File, save as. Now carefully observe. Instead of D, I'm going to save it by using different name. Class name is D, but what I'll do, I'm going to give different name. Simply I will say hello world without giving any space. Class name is D, but file name I'm giving hello world. Okay, save. What you can do is, what is the file name? File name is hello world. Okay, that is what we should do here. What is the file name here? Hello world.java. We should compile hello world.java. Hello world.java. After compilation, go to the classes folder. Go to the classes folder. You will get D data class. File name is hello world.java. File name is hello world. But what is the generated class file? It is D. Because this is the class name. This one we need to run. Okay. This one we need to run. So for running, we know that I can go for -cp --classes D. Press enter, you'll get done as the message. Fine, no issues. That means I can able to give any name for the class, and by saving I can able to give name as anything. No issues. I can able to give class name as anything. I can able to give file name as anything. No issues. But observe this condition. File new Java. Simply I'm going to copy everything from the previous program. Paste it here. Name, I'm going to, class name is going to give it as, this is a different class, no, that is why. Then I'm going to give it as public. I'm going to name this class as, I'm going to give public keyword. Save this. File, save as. Then I'll try to save this with a different name. Okay, like hello world again. File name, hello world again. We can skip the Dart Java extension. Now carefully observe, class name is different, file name is different. Click on save. What is the difference to the previous program? It is, I have given the public keyword here before the class. Save it. Now try to compile. Wait for the surprise. Name of the file, hello world again. Okay, that is the file name. If you get confusion, I'll type Java C -d double dot forward slash classes. Hello world again. Dot Java. I'm getting error, syntax error. What is the syntax error? Class is public, should be declared in a file named e.java. Class is public, yes, class is public. If the class is declared with the public keyword, then file name must be class name. That is what it is saying. Class is public, should be declared in a file named e.java. Plus, you should create a file called e.java. There you should keep this public class e. If any class is declared as public, this is Java file, okay? This is Java file, dot Java. This is dot Java file. In this dot Java file, you can able to create any number of classes, no issues. Any number of classes you can able to create for each and every class. For each and every class, Java C compiler is going to generate that class file. No issues. But if at least one class declared with the public keyword, if at least one class is declared with the public keyword, then that class name must be the file name. If any one class is declared with the public keyword, then that class name must be the file name. Here, class name is different, file name is different, and this class got declared as public. Whichever the class got declared as public, that class name must be the file name. Here, different case. Class name is different, file name is different. Not possible. That is why we are getting this error. Now, I'll develop the same program. Observe. New Java. I'm going to give the name as F because it is a different program. Now I'll save it by using F only. Save as F. Save it. Now try to compile. F got declared with the public keyword. File name is F. Class name also F. File name is F. Class name also F. And this class got declared with the public keyword. Try to compile. Syntactically proper. You can run also. No issues. You'll get that done as a message. From these examples, what you can able to learn is, if a class declared as public, that class name must be the file name. If you are developing class without a public keyword, if you are developing a class without a public keyword, then you can able to give file name as anything. Class name can be anything, file name can be anything, no issues at all. You can able to give the file name as anything. Whenever you are compiling, you will give the file name, but when you are running, when you are running, you will give the class name, no issues. But if you are giving class, if you are declaring class with public keyword, then class name and file name must be same. Come to the next example. Copy the same thing. Paste it. In one Java file, I can able to develop any number of classes. In one Java file, I can able to develop any number of classes. Going for H. This is done from G. This is done from H. Now carefully observe. Two public classes are there. This is one Java file. Two public classes are there. Now observe. File, save as. So what should I give? Either I should go for G or H. Or I don't want anything. I'll go for simply different name. Hello world. Again and again. Save. We already know that we will get error. Okay, answer. We'll compile. Hello world. Again and again. Two errors we are getting. Bus. Class is public. You should declare that class in a file named g.java. Same H also. Two errors we are getting. Fine. Now what I'll do is I'll copy everything. File new Java. I'll go for I. Save it by using I. Save. File name is I. Here I have one public class called I. Save it. Now try to compile. You'll get one error. Carefully observe. Here it is I. I.java. Class J is public, should be declared in a file named J.java. It is fine, whatever you have done. Class name is I, file name is I, fine. But one more public class is there. What about this one? That is what we are getting here. In one Java file, you can able to develop any number of classes. In one Java file, you can able to develop any number of classes. But maximum, only one class can be declared as public. But maximum, only one class can be declared as public. If any one class got declared as public, then that class name must be the file name. if any class declared as public, then that class name must be the file name. These are all the rules. Observe another program, file new, Java. Okay. L. I'm going to delete this public for this. You know, we cannot. And I'm going to keep another class. L, M. This is N. This is L. This is M. This is N. Fine. File save as. We know that this file must be saved with the class name as K because that is public. Save it. Okay, fine. Come to the command prompt. I'm going to compile this K.java. Perfectly fine. No issues at all. Now what happens, it is going to generate k dot class, l dot class, m dot class, n dot class. K, L, M, N. All these class got created. Now which class I want, that class I can able to run. Suppose I want K class to be run. Class, sorry, what I'm getting here, I did not modify it. So modify it to K. See, another point here, it is, if you are making a single change, if you are making any changes to the Java file, compulsory you should save it, then you should compile it. Keep these two things in mind. If you are making any changes, you should save it first initially. Make sure that it is saved. Then you should compile it once again. It is going to generate a new bytecode. Okay. Then I can able to run. What happens after you are compiling? All these files will be replaced. Okay. Whatever the files has been generated previously, that got replaced with whatever the new files has been generated from recent compilation. Now I can able to run K. Yes, of course. Done from K. I can able to run L class. Done from L. What is the other class M we have? L. L I have already. N we have. For any program, main method is the starting point. For any program, main method is the starting point. If I say, if I try to run N, what happens? It is going to search for main method. It is going to search for main method in the N class. If I say K, if I want to run K, by using Java command, if I try to run K, it is going to search for main method in the K class. This is a starting point of a program. Fine. So enough for today. We'll continue tomorrow. same timings, 8 to 10. Tomorrow also, demo class. You can able to attend it for free. Now I'm going to update this repository. Commit. Second. Fine. I can push it to the main branch. Later onwards in the afternoon, I'm going to send assignments. That assignment you can able to find it in the resources folder. I have already sent this link in the chat. Make sure that you have completed your assignment before coming to the next class. So for the full stack, whoever enrolled for full stack, so I'm going to cover complete core Java, basics and advanced. Then SQL, complete SQL, JDBC, servlets, JSP, then before starting servlets, I'm going to cover web development. Okay, before starting servlet, I'm going to cover some of the basics of web development like HTML, CSS. Then after servlet and JSP, I'm going to cover JavaScript, then any one of the framework, React or Angular, most probably React. And in HTML, CSS, JavaScript, I'm going to develop one or two projects using React, maybe one or two project, by using JavaScript, one or two project. After that, Spring and Hibernate, complete Spring and Hibernate. It will be Spring Boot, Spring MVC, AOP, DI. These are all the modules in Spring environment, in Spring ecosystem. Based on Spring and Hibernate, I'm going to develop one project. Apart from this, logical coding, how to print patterns, and for example, how to find out a factorial of a number, you know, it is comes under logical coding. Like this, I'm going to cover in this logical coding part, I'm going to cover around maybe, I don't know, like 50 problems. Okay, it is very important for interviews. Then I'm going to cover GitHub. That is also very important. So all this comes under full stack Java package. Fine. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. If you have any doubts, don't ask any doubts. If you don't have any doubts, we can wind up.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, fine. We'll continue tomorrow, 8 a.m. Okay, if any changes is there, I'll update in the group. Okay? Tomorrow, 8 a.m. tomorrow also demo. Okay guys, we'll wind up the class. We'll continue tomorrow. I'm going to send the assignment later onwards. I'll send the notification. Please finish the assignment and attend the tomorrow's class.
Thank you, sir.
Have a good day. Bye.